it's really interesting because as a non-surgeon, we've all read about Penfield and the whole notion of what it's like as you probe the brain in order to cut out an area that, as you would stimulate, you can evoke some very, very interesting memories or other events. And that tends to be, he often was operating in the temporal lobe where memories are thought to be stored or where they at least can be brought up. What we found, and much to our great interest when we first started, because we didn't know what we were going to have happen. This is not an area of the brain that is been operated on for anything like this, ever. So when this area of the brain is damaged, it can be from an aneurysm. It's just not an area that anyone knows a whole lot about to be stimulating. But as you enter into this area, you don't actually get any of these evoked memories, but when we actually turned the contacts on, we were amazed by the fact, and I remember very distinctly the first patient, not the first contact we tested, which gave her she had no response at any voltage, but we got to the second contact and got up to a moderate amount of current, and she all of a sudden said, "Did you just do something? I have this intense sense of calm or relief." And then she kind of had this very kind of puzzled expression on her face. And she says, "It's just so hard to describe." And I said, "Well, what's it like? Do you feel like?" And I had this immediate thought, "Oh, this is like Penfield, you know, she's having some memory thing." And she goes, "It's just so hard to surprise. It's like that first day of spring when the crocus just pop up through the snow." And I'm going, wait a minute, are you seeing crocus? And then she goes, "No," and she kind of like throws her hand out, and you have to imagine someone's in this frame, and they're lying on a hospital bed, and everyone's sitting in the room, and everybody like comes to total attention, and she's a sweet woman, and she just kind of throws her hand, no, you know, like, "You idiot, you know, I'm not talking about seeing flowers." I don't know what she's talking about. She goes, "I'm trying to think of something that evokes this kind of emotional state, this kind of calm and satisfaction." Turned out this woman was a gardener. We lived in Toronto. It was as if she realized that first day when you walk outside in spring and you see the flowers, it's a sense of renewal. It's a sense of, it's the start of spring. It was the most amazing and poetic statement. And she was groping, quite frankly, for something that was like the feeling she had, even though the feeling itself was very ethereal and very hard to explain. That was one of the most amazing. Although other patients would get a change in state, you could see it on their face before they recognized it. It was as if, you know, when patients are this ill, there's a painness to their face. If they walk past you on the street, you always think, boy, that person must have had a bad day. They look like that all the time. And when we would get to the right contact, we've gotten to where you can watch their facial expression and you can actually just see it relax. Or you'll have a patient say, "It feels like, did you turn the lights up? There's like a lifting." There are so many interesting phenomena that to try, it's not mapping it in the same way that Penfield did, where you can evoke a reproducible memory of an event or a time, but you're actually seeing that we are in the emotion control system that is being controlled. It's sort of hijacked, and as it's released, it's a real state of calm, relief, lifting. One patient said, "You know, when you're depressed, you're so turned inward."
Sorry.
"When you're depressed, you're so turned inward. It doesn't matter what anybody outside you says. You cannot pay attention to them. And whatever you just did, I can take attention away from myself and attend to you." So again, we're in this fundamental area of the brain that when it is dysfunctional, it hijacks you. Your emotions hijack anything else you can possibly do. And there's something about this small amount of current in this very specific place that allows the system to just re-equilibrate. And it isn't about becoming happy or becoming engaged in a exaggerated way. It's just actually allowing your brain to be back in your own control. And figuring that out is the coolest part of science that anybody can hope to participate in.